everyone, very good morning to all of you. This is Ishani Trivedi from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome back to the session of Building Construction Technology, the subject in which we were discussing about the module Building Components, right? Now, in the Building Components, in the last session, we had completed with the flooring, if you remember. We had discussed about the ground floor, we discussed about the upper floor, and then we moved to the third type, that is your topmost story, your topmost floor of a building, of a structure, that is known as roof, right? Roof and also along with the roof, we will study about the roof covering. Now students, if you remember, I had discussed about the basic concepts of the roof, right? We had talked about the different types of roof. As I said, that we will have only three classification of the roof, right? We will have a flat roof, which is obvious to you. We will have pitch roof, which also you have seen in our rural areas, in village areas, sometimes in urban areas also. And for the Western countries, for the foreign countries, this type of roof is very much common, right? If you have towns, villages, if I talk about specifically European countries, right? Then most of the small cities and towns and villages have this type of roof at every places, right? Also, one of the important factors over there is the frost, right? Winter. Because of the pitch roof, your snow which is accumulated, right? Also, when we talk about the loads, right? We know about the dead load, we know about the live load, we know earthquake load. There is also one more load known as snow load, right? Wind load is also prominent to you when we talk about high-rise building. But what about the snow load? Right, whenever it when snowfall takes place in such cold countries, then it is accumulated on their on the roof, right? And it is necessary to remove them, otherwise they will exert load on the roof. In analysis also, snow load is taken into account when you talk about such countries where winter is very much extreme. And because of this pitch roof, the snow can be removed easily, it will slide off. So in those countries and those places, such type of roof is very much common. In our country also, this type of roofing is common. And the third type of roof which I discussed was the curved roof, right? The curved roof or the domes, or in the factories where the curved roof are provided. Also for architectural purpose, different type of aspects, different type of attractive appearance, you can provide curved roof as well. Now we are moving to the first concept, technical terms of a roof. Then we will move forward with the classification, and then we will discuss about various types specifically. But first, before moving to that, we will discuss about the certain technical terms regarding to the roof. If I talk about the technical terms, we are considering over here pitch roof or slope roof. Both of them are same. So let us discuss about the technical terms. Look at the image flashing above me. You can see in the image, each and every technical word is shown very precisely, right? And you have all variations in one image itself. Because your roof, you have, can you see that? You also have the pitch roof and you also have the flat roof, right? Flat roof is provided for the garage, right? For the parking, for the parking garage, flat roof is provided, and to the rest of the house, pitch roof is provided, right? Now for the pitch roof also, you can see that we have two different pitch roof. You also have the dormer window. If you remember about the dormer window, I had talked about gable window and dormer window. So here dormer is provided, you can see that. This image is very much precise if you want to understand all components of the roof. Now let us talk one by one about them. In this session, we are only going to discuss about all the technical terms, which are around 11 to 12, okay? So the first one, which is the first technical term over here, we have the span. Now if I talk about span, it means the clear distance between the two supports. If I talk about span of the floor, span of the roof, span of the room, then how do you define the span? It is the clear distance between the supports. If it is arch, if it is beam, or if it is roof truss, if it is flat roof, then it is the clear distance between the two supports, end supports, right? Obviously, your roof is going to rest on some certain support which is fixed in the wall. Okay, so distance between the two supports is your first definition, span. Second, what do you have? Rise. Rise is already studied in the arch also. It was the clear vertical distance between the crown, that was your center, center view, sir, center wedge, and between the imaginary line passing near the two supports, that was span. Same over here, what is rise? Vertical distance between the top of the ridge. Now in the arch we called it as crown, the centerpiece, right? Here we are calling the centerpiece or the center line of the pitch roof as ridge. We will define it technically, but for now understand. If you want to see where the ridge is located in the image, then find out it is there at the top. So the clear vertical distance between the top of the ridge and the wall plate, right? Wall plate where your supports will lie, that clear vertical distance is known as rise. Next, third technical definition we are talking about is ridge. Spot the ridge in the image. I told you already. What can you see? It is the top part, right? The center part, the top center part. Let us call it as apex. Apex means the top center. Center means apex. So the apex line of the sloping roof. It means your full line, the full line, full member which is provided, right, which is your topmost center of the pitch roof, that apex line. Here you are not considering the member, you are considering the line. Okay, that apex line of the sloping roof, apex means this topmost center, that is known as ridge. Ridge is also the term used for mountains. You know, mountains and ridges and valleys, different types of words are used, right? So it refers to the mountain also. That means the topmost, the apex point is known as ridge. Next you have is eaves, right? Next we have is eaves. Remember the word eaves. Can you spot the eaves in the image? Yes, you can. It is just provided on the right side. You can see that it is provided near the hip. Now what is eaves? It means the lower edge of the inclined roof surface. You have the inclined roof surface. It is going to end somewhere. So the lower edge, the edge, right? Where it ends and the edge part, right? Where your sloping roof has the edge, the lower edge is known as eaves. Next parameter you have is hip. Now what is a hip? Again, spot that technical word in the image. You can see that. Now it says the ridge formed by intersection of two sloping surfaces. Okay, we have one sloping surface, we have another sloping surface, and the ridge formed by it, right? You know ridge, it means the apex line. You can spot the hip also in the image as well. So the ridge, the apex line, the ridge which is formed by intersection of two sloping surfaces, not two different roof, two sloping surfaces, right, where the exterior angle is almost 180 degrees, that is known as hip. Next, valley. Now reverse of the hip, I told you that the intersection of two sloping roof will make the hip, and intersection of two different pitch roof. Spot the valley in the image. I think that is going to make it clear to you. Can you see that? Just near the ridge, valley is shown. Okay, so it is the reverse of the hip. It says the intersection of two different roof surfaces. You can see one roof you have is in one direction and another roof is going towards this direction. Can you see that? Yes, so the intersection of two sloping roof, right, that part which angle is also less than 180 degrees, that is known as valley. See, you can match these words to a mountain. For the mountain you will have the ridge, you will have the hip, and you will have the valley, right? So the same is matched over here, that you have is valley. Next what do we have? The next definition which is flashing over here is ridge piece. Now, I already told you students that the apex line, okay, again look at the image. Where can you see the ridge? You have it at the apex part, the topmost part, your center part of the two sides of sloping sides of the roof. Now, I already told you that ridge is the apex line, okay, but now that actual structural member, you have to provide a structural member over there, right? So that structural member, that horizontal structural member, which can be either made up of wood, that is timber, or steel, because generally we have two different types of truss, a wooden truss, that is your wooden roof truss, and a steel roof truss, right? So the horizontal member, let us look at the technical definition itself. How does it say? It says that the horizontal wooden member or the steel member, it can be in the form of a beam or a board, right? Look at the ridge in the image. Can you see a horizontal member, right? It is a the structural member, that horizontal member which is provided at the apex, which is provided at the ridge, is known as ridge piece. Okay, so understand the difference between the ridge and the ridge piece. Okay, students, now moving forward to the next definition. Next, what do we have? Next definition which is flashing over here is common rafter. Now, for the common rafter, let me show you another image, a more clarified image. Can you see in the sketch now? What can you see over here? Only two elements are shown. Okay, now the sloping sides of the roof. How is a pitch roof made? You have to connect two inclined horizontal members, right? You have to connect two members which are nothing but wooden beams or wooden planks or steel members, right? Both of them are inclined and you have to connect both of them, and that makes your, yes, it makes your rafter, okay? So the inclined wooden members, okay, not horizontal. If I said horizontal, then please correct that. The inclined members, the structural members which are connected with each other, and that forms your basic skeleton of your pitch roof, is known as rafter. Now you can also call it as common rafter. Okay, so technically, how do you define technically? Please make sure that in short questions also, all of these definitions are going to be very important, because it will be asked and it will become a little bit tough also if it is asked in short questions. So prepare accordingly. Now, let us define it technically. What does it say? It says that the inclined wooden members, which I already mentioned, running from the ridge to the eaves. Now going more technicality, into more technicality, you know what is the ridge, that is the apex, and you know the eaves, which is at the lower edge, okay? So the inclined member which is running from the apex, that is the ridge, up to the eaves, that is known as common rafter. Now in the image which is flashing, the sketch which is flashing over here, you can see that number of common rafters are provided, and that makes your skeleton for the pitch roof. And on top of that, coverings will be provided, and then the roof construction shall be completed. Now, they are fixed to the purlins at intermediate point and support the battens and boarding to support the roof covering. Now let us move to the next definition, that is purlins. What are purlins? Look at the sketch above. Can you see the horizontal members? Yes, the horizontal members connecting all the common rafters. Okay, the horizontal members, I repeat, horizontal members, structural members, either wooden members or steel members, which are connecting all of your common rafters, and wherever they are intersecting, they are nailed together, they are cogged together, that is known as purlins. Now, why do you need to provide purlins? For the support of the common rafter. See, if you only carry out the construction of common rafters and directly provide the coverings, it is not going to be stable, it will not carry the load which is required. So what you have to do is, you have to provide another intermediate support, braces, that are the horizontal members, right? What are they called? They are known as purlins. So now, this sketch will make you clear about the common rafters and the purlins. all of these are nothing but structural members only, but since they have different purposes and different locations and different construction, that is why you have to remember what are common rafter and purlins. Now based on this, you will have plenty of varieties of different type of pitch roof construction, which we are going to study in the later sessions. Okay, now what do we have? Eaves board. You know what is eaves by now, correct? Eaves means the lower part of the inclined portion, the inclined member, the lower edge. Now at that edge, it is just like ridge and ridge piece. Eaves and eaves board. The actual member which is provided at the eaves, the wooden member or the steel member, that board, the boarding will be known as eaves board. How does it say technically? It says wooden plank or board fixed to the feet of the common rafter. That is the lower edge of the common rafter is known as eaves board. Next, what do we have? Wall plate. Now, let us read it first and then understand. Long wooden members which are provided on the top of stone or brick wall for the purpose of fixing the feet of the common rafters. Now you have the two sloping sides, you have the two common rafters, correct? Now where will those common rafters rest? Where are you going to fix it? On the wall, the two sides of the wall. Now when you want to fix that to the two sides of the wall, you will have to have an intermediate member, right? By which you can nail it, you can cog it, you can have the joint over there, and you can fix it into the wall with wedges, and those members are specifically known as wall plates. So basically when you want to fix the common rafters, when you want the common rafters to sit at its position, you will have to have at the bottom most, at the wall, you will have to have structural members where you can fix the common rafter with wedges or with joints or with nails, that are known as wall plates. Okay, one more definition we can take over here is the flat roof. Okay, for the flat roof, again I am flashing the image which we saw earlier. Okay, you can see in this sketch, do we have flat roof? Yes, but where is it provided? It is provided over the garage. Okay, so for the house, if there is a garage, if there is a parking, if there is also a shed, if you want to provide a shed or a row house or a storage house, then on top of that, if you are providing the roof completely flat, then it becomes your flat roof. So your full sketch is a combination of pitch roof and flat roof both. Again, go through all the technical terms in the sketch. We have ridge, we have valley, we have eaves, and with eaves we can talk about eaves board. Then we have ridge and ridge piece. Okay, we have the flat roof, we have rafters and purlins, the intersection, as I said, if two roof are intersecting and if two sloping part are intersecting, then both of them will have different names. Okay students, so I think all of the technical terms are taken over here, and in the next session we can discuss further about the specific classification of different types of roof and further detailed classification which we have to study according to your syllabus. So students, let us keep up to here till now. You are clear with the technical terms of the roof. I suggest that you go through all of them, otherwise you will not be able to understand the classification of pitch roof in detail. Because in the sketches, all of these members and technical terms will be directly labeled. Okay, so I suggest you go through all of the terms and remember them and then watch the next sessions. Okay students, have a good day. Thank you.